So I am waiting for you to provide five reasons why me as a non-Muslim and why this gentleman as a non-Muslim should convert to Islam. Okay, I'm waiting.
It's more coherent than your book.
Why pick up me?
For me, the Quran, it just makes more sense. There's no talking snakes in the Quran like your weird book. Yeah? The Quran is a much better book. It's far superior than the Bible. 100%. Not even close.
Where does the sun go in at night? Where does the sun go in at night?
Have you not heard of poetic language? So why did we say sunspots?
I'm going to break it down first.
No, no, no. Answer me this. Does the sun literally set?
Islam is the pure monotheist religion.
We're talking about your
Christianity is not. From your understanding. I am Christian. My scripture teaches me I must only and only worship one true God. My scripture doesn't give me any right to worship something else or someone else.
The Bible says the world's on pillars.
I want you to
look at your own book.
The Quran, back it up. What was your assumptions or understanding that you come to the conclusion Christianity is not monotheist religion? My second thing is, I want you to unpack for me. Second thing is,
how old did you want?
As you said, Islam is the monotheist religion. I would like you to just tell me,
how
come Spirit of Allah can give life and create exactly the way Allah does?
Well, I don't want to talk
about anyone. How come Spirit of Allah, which is part of Allah,
have you had a toothpaste?
It's a perfect man. Has come, word of Allah is going to appear as man. And has come, Muslims must obey Muhammad the way they obey Allah. For me, that's shirk. It's written all over it. There's a big
the notion that this guy shirk, the guy to prove shirk, Islam after shirk. 1400 years.
So I've got two there questions and I would love you to respond to my two questions.
It's much smarter than you. Just realize how far behind you are.
First question is, I want you to clarify what were your assumptions? What made you to think and understand Christianity is a polytheist religion? And the second one, I need you to back up, Islam is a monotheist religion after the claims I made about Islam.
So my assumption isn't sort of attached to any religion. It's the assumption I've made for myself, which is any religion can claim that there's one God, but then God could have, say, three parts, one part, like as in be completely united as one entity, or God can be like a million things. So for example, in Hinduism, they believe in one God, but they have like idolatry, they have like a representation.
For
Christianity, my like this is what I'm saying. I still see belief in a non-unitarian God as being polytheistic or have elements of polytheism. So I'm saying from a dictionary definition, Christianity, according to a Trinitarian understanding, can still be monotheistic. However, that doesn't sort of sit with my personal understanding of what polytheism is.
So even though from the dictionary definition, you identified Christian as a monotheist religion, but you say, oh, you know much better than dictionary, because Christian faith does not match with dictionary, while dictionary says Christian religion is a monotheist religion. So that's already confirmed. There is a false thinking
over. Firstly,
I'm going to give you time to first respond to my two questions in one go, and I will come back to them, okay?
Yeah, I don't remember the second question. The
second question was, you need to prove for me, give me your evidence that Islam is a monotheist religion.
Okay, so from that then I would say, okay, to explain how Islam is a monotheistic religion, I would go to the Quran and go to
do you speak Greek or Hebrew?
Chapter number is probably 111.
It has nothing to do with my question. Yeah. Let me read the passage, verse, chapter you were looking.
Yes.
So, Surah 112. My question to you, I want you to prove for me, Islam is a monotheist religion. Remember, you have not fulfilled your first answer to your first question. Say, he is Allah. One. Allah is Allah.
Why are you covering those? That's
the
question.
He does
work. I know you're in a moment. Right now,
he's okay with it being recorded. So.
Okay, he's alright being recorded.
Says he is Allah. Allah, yeah, man. The eternal refuge, he need a begot.
Yeah, exactly. That means he's
wrong. No? Is that to him? It seems to say Allah doesn't begot anything. It doesn't have anything to do with my question.
I asked him. He's
being aggressive.
How's he
being
aggressive?
Oh, now he's aggressive.
I apologize for being aggressive.
So he's alright. He's alright to be recorded. So he had to be.
No, he says that he doesn't want to be filmed.
This verse does not tell me Islam is a monotheist religion. So, this verse simply says, say, he is Allah one, Allah, the eternal refuge. He neither begot, nor he is born, nor is there to him any equivalent. So, my question to you was simply, give me the references that we
Is that not in the Bible? I told you, if Islam is the monotheist religion,
how come the Spirit of Allah comes and then gives life exactly the way Allah does? Okay? How come Jesus creates exactly the way Allah does? Let me finish. Also, can you please also unpack for me, if Islam is monotheist religion, why you must obey Allah and you must obey Muhammad? That is, shirk is written all over it with the capital letters, okay? That's something you need to think about it. Also, when it comes to the Spirit of Allah, okay? According to Quran, the Spirit of Allah is all present, all knowing, and all powerful. That's all shirk.
According to
current definition, yeah. That was never the case. So I am reading it from Surah 19. I am sure as someone who chose to be Muslim, you already studied the Quran and then you made your own decisions. It shouldn't be too long for you to answer this basic question. So, Surah 19, verse 16, and mentioned in the book Mary, when she withdrew from her family to a place towards to east, and she took in seclusion from them a secret. Then we sent her a robe, okay? Then he represented himself to her as a well-proportioned man, okay? Spirit of Allah, which is part of Allah, appears as a perfect man. So, just a moment, I'm going to continue. So, are you happy for your brother to join the conversation? Okay, so, in that case, can you make your case that the Spirit of Allah is separated from Allah according to this verse?
Okay, so you've raised a lot of things, which is good. So one of the things you spoke about was... My name's Imran.
Nice to meet you.
No, likewise. So one of the things you spoke
about... Speak
like
a man!
One of the things that you spoke about was the plus 112. Yeah. Now it's the monotheism is clear from the verse, and I'll tell you why. Because it says Allah the Ahad, the unique one. Yeah. This is a statement that He is one uniquely.
So unique one.
Uniquely,
unique apple. Unique card. Last brand new apple.
So uniquely God. Yeah. Now what does that mean? So you said uniquely apple or brownie or these things. So you're referring to something that we know there are multiples of. The ahad means actually there is one. So you can't. You can say you have one pen. You can't. If you say you have an ahad pen, that means that is like nothing else. You cannot bring anything else like this thing.
Okay, unpack this for me. I've got one glasses. Okay. How many? What is the name of those things? Glass. How many glass in this glasses?
In your glasses, there are two glasses.
So this is one glasses, yet has two glasses in it for me to see. I need to put it on, I can't see without
glasses. Because you have two eyes.
So I have one hand, one unique hand, amazing. Let's count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fingers. So one hand, 5 fingers, okay?
So
what is it with Allah?
So first of all, he's taking two separate words, wahid, which means one, with the word ahad. They're two different words. They're commonly translated as one, but they're not the same thing. You have a wahid hand with 5 fingers to it. What you're implying then...
Sir, you need to speak up.
Well, this is how I speak. I'm not speaking for the crowd, I'm speaking to my sister. So you have wahid, which is one. That can refer to one apple, one hand, one whatever. Then you have ahad. Ahad means unique. You're making the claim that because my hand has 5 fingers, that the word wahid or ahad can be multiple. That doesn't follow.
Why not?
Now, because your hand, you're dividing your hand. You're dividing your hand.
Did I divide my fingers? My hand, 5 fingers. Hand is different, fingers are different.
So, no.
I am one human being with 2 eyes, with billions of brain cells, with 2 feet.
So what you're arguing for is components for God. This is what you're saying, yes?
No, I'm asking you to explain the verse to me.
I have explained the verse. But what you're saying, you have issue with the word wa'ahid. You're saying one.
I have issue with that verse, Surah 112, to identify Islam as the religions of monotheists. Okay? I ask your brother, verse he brought it in Surah 112, he asked. So, that doesn't justify, that doesn't answer my question. Because even though Muslim tells us Islam is wonderful monotheist religion, yet I look at the Quran, it's not only Muslims are like capital letter shirk, Quran is shirk of law, okay? Muhammad and Allah is in the same category. You must obey Allah, you must obey Muhammad. If you obey Muhammad, therefore Allah will do these things for you. Spirit of Allah.
You said lots of things and we're going to get lost in there.
So I'm just summarizing why I don't think Islam is not monotheist religion. So that's first. Muhammad is pretty high in Islam, even much higher than Allah. You can say astaghfirullah, but
sister,
that doesn't work.
Spirit
of Allah.
Can I say something? You know, when you make claims about someone else's religion, particularly about Islam, it's probably good to get their understanding of what they believe. Because I know as a Christian, you don't believe what I believe. I know that. You don't believe that we're monotheistic? Fine. I have no problem with that. That's up to you.
I have a problem with that.
No, you have a problem. You should have a problem with that as well, because
shirk is going to take you to hell.
Let me just take an example. So I don't have a problem with you not agreeing with Islam. I don't. Go for it. No problem.
So you don't even concern for my eternity?
It's up to you. Let's get all emotional and talk about your eternity, but let's start with the basics first. So the Quran says...
I am here. Because I'm concerned for your eternity. It's just heartbreaking that you don't even care what I believe. That's fine.
No, that's not what I've said. But that's fine. If you want to believe that, that's not entirely up to you. So the first point is that the Quran says He is Allah the Ahad. Qul huwa Allahu Ahad. Ahad means uniquely Allah. There's no divisions in Allah. There's no head and tail and spirit and body and spirit or anything like this. There is only Allah. Now, you try to divide Allah some way, like you're dividing a hand. This is a false analogy. It doesn't follow. Ahad means uniquely one.
Now, you can't make a division in life. You want to make a division? Go for it. Show me the division. Now, you've tried to do that. You've gone to Sura 19, and you've spoken about the spirit of Allah. And your claim is... Your claim is that this spirit somehow is like Allah. You haven't given any evidence that this is the case.
Okay, let me do that.
Let me explain my position first. So, we know that Allah can send angels and messengers to give the message to the people. He does that. This does not make the angel or the messenger like the creator. It doesn't do that. So, for example, Allah is ever living. The Prophet Muhammad died. Yeah? Moses died. This does not make them like Allah. Allah is all-knowing. The Prophet didn't know when the end would come. The same way Jesus didn't know when the hour would come. This shows that they are not like Allah. So Allah is something different. The other concept we have, it says there is nothing like unto Him. So if you see an angel, you see a man, you see a tree, you see the river, none of these things are like Allah. Why? Because it specifically says there is nothing like unto Him.
Okay, I'm gonna stop you on that. Reason for that is, here's the thing.
So I'm just...
If there is nothing like Allah, I think that's something Christians and Muslims can believe. As a Christian, I believe there is nothing like God. Muslims, it's good to hear Muslims believe that as well. But here's my problem. I did not compare or give any credit to any angels or any messengers.
I'm trying to get as close as possible.
Put them in the category of Allah. I did that. I never give you an example. Therefore, this angel is Allah. I never say that. I never say therefore this messenger is Allah. I am questioning Muhammad, word of Allah, and I'm questioning the spirit of Allah. Okay? So
let's go Surah, one by one.
Yeah, Surah 19, verse 17. Talking about the spirit of Allah. It is the spirit of Allah comes and gives life. Okay? So, can you just justify for me, how did you come to the conclusion that spirit of Allah has nothing to do with Allah?
Okay, so you said that the spirit of Allah gives life.
Becomes a perfect human being.
And gives life.
You can't be perfect, I think you are like too fast for being perfect, right? But spirit of Allah becomes human and then gives life.
Gives life? Where did you get the gives life from?
Surah 19, verse 17. Surah Spirit of Allah reveals to Mary. Surah 66, Spirit of Allah gives life.
So can we go through the verses so I understand?
And then Surah 58 is the Spirit of Allah, He's all powerful, all present, okay?
So let's go through these things here. So you made the claim that Surah 19 says that the Spirit of Allah gives life. So I'm going to read through. You said verse 19, yes?
No, verse 16 to read it until 19.
Okay, so let's start from verse 16. And mentioned in the book, the story of the Quran. O Muhammad, this is in brackets. I'm going to remove the brackets from my reading, okay? And mentioned in the book, O Muhammad, the story of Mary when she withdrew in seclusion from her family to a place facing east. 17. She placed a screen from them, then we sent to her our Ruh, yeah, our spirit. And he appeared before her in the form of a man in all respects. So he came as a man.
Who is this spirit?
The spirit of Allah, yeah?
The spirit of Allah. Yeah. Is it part of Allah, separated from Allah?
So it's a creation, like an angel.
So it is the creation, spirit of Allah. The Down syndrome baby. It is the creation of Allah.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. It's not Allah.
Okay, so, just a moment. I need you to back that up. Spirit of Allah, you stated, is a creation created by Allah and it is not like Allah. Okay? Give me your reference.
So, what is it that you disagree with?
So, I would love you to give me any verse from well-detailed and well-explained Quran. Spirit is identified as a created being.
Okay. So, I give you that? Okay, I'll find it for you right now. Just give me a second and I'll give it to you.
So, people ask, who is this spirit? Okay?
Where is that?
Surah 17, verse 85.
Can you bring it up for me? I'll have a look at it.
So, people ask, who is this spirit all about? Okay? Because people were a bit funny if the spirit is really the really way you are telling it's created and has nothing to do with Allah. And they ask you about the ruh. Say, the ruh is all, ruh is of the effect of my Lord. And you have not given the knowledge except a little. So this verse simply tells me it is Allah who knows what is ruh or who is ruh.
Oh, I'm sorry, you are
making a statement that you know much better than Muhammad and much better than the Quran, which is saying spirit is a created being.
So the claim that you've made, from my understanding, I could be misrepresenting you, so tell me. The claim that you've made is that spirit is Allah. That's what you've said. Has the same creative power and gives life.
Is the spirit part of Allah or not?
No. And gives life. Now, your argument...
And all present, all knowing. Yeah.
You say all present and all knowing. And you claim this as an argument from silence. And you say because there is no statement that says it's not.
No. It's an argument from silence.
No, you're making an argument from silence.
So,
let me explain.
Muhammad tell us what this spirit is. Muhammad can't say knowledge is only belong to Allah about the spirit. But today you are making a claim which goes against the Quran while you are saying spirit is created because you know much better than Allah.
So this is sort of rhetoric. So what you're saying is that the spirit is Allah. You made that claim, no, not backed up with anything.
Is spirit, let me just speak.
Let's just stand. It's attached to you.
Daniel, get away from the camera. Daniel, back off.
So you've made the claim that the spirit is Allah. That's a claim you've made. There's nothing in the Quran that tells you that. An Islamic understanding is that this is not the case, that the spirit is a created thing. Then you've quoted another passage where somebody asks Prophet Muhammad about the spirit, the soul. Because in Islam we don't have a differentiation between the spirit and the soul. This is a Christian separation of these two things. So you have body, spirit and soul.
What is the Arabic word for soul?
So nefes. No, nefes means self. It has three different applications. Okay? It can mean soul, it can mean self. It has different applications depending on the context of the word and it's used in the verse.
Can you back that up?
Yes, I can back that.
Yeah, let's back that up.
Sure, but...
Let's talk first of all, break it down and then back it up for me. So your reference that spirit is created.
So the first thing, Allah says he is unique. There's nothing like him. Everyone has a soul, which is spirit. So this automatically...
Allah had a great opportunity when soul and spirit are the same thing.
Where does it say?
Allah doesn't do that.
No, I didn't say they're the same thing.
In the Quran, you've got the soul, different Arabic word. You've got the ruh, spirit in different Arabic
word.
They are different translated, okay. Written in the Arabic Quran. Okay. They are two different
words. So let's go into the further. So first of all, the Quran says Allah is Ahad, he is uniquely God. And then it says also, there is nothing like unto him. So nothing is like unto him. So whatever you can think of that is more available, it's not Allah by definition. Because why? Allah is unique and there is nothing like him. We all have a soul. We all have a spirit. Right?
I do not agree with that because Quran uses the different word for soul and different word for the spirit. So you need to first of all back it up that Quran states soul and spirit are the same. You need to back that up. And then also you need to back it up for me. Spirit has been created by Allah.
So everything...
If spirit is created by Allah, why would Allah, in whole creation, this unique, wonderful Allah, why would Allah give his powers to something else he created? Is Allah committing shirk?
So first of all,
give me your references.
Okay, one second. Because you're taking an argument.
Give me your references and then we move from that.
Let's
after
have,
you tell me.
Let's have a discussion.
Yes, after you back it up for me, Allah created the spirit, so what you and then I will bring my next argument.
The first thing is this. You've already made a definition that you're asking me to refute. You're saying that the spirit is uncreated. You're saying that.
I'm not saying that.
Okay, so the spirit is not uncreated.
I'm not saying that. You are the one who's saying spirit is created.
No.
I want you to back it up. No. So, spirit, let's do very basic, okay? Is your arm part of you or not?
Me once.
Is your arm, a hand, part of you or part of you
not? It's part of my body.
It's part of your body. Is the spirit of Allah part of Allah or not part of Allah? So spirit of Allah is not part of the Allah. Give me verse from the Quran which tells you if it is not part of Allah, Allah must be creating it, okay? So, can you give me the verse from the Quran or from the Islamic, let's go, from the Quran, let's go first, that tells you spirit of, thank you, spirit of Allah is created.
So, the spirit of Allah. So, okay, drink your water first because you might need some energy.
Sorry, not sharing, it's about to finish.
That's fine. I didn't expect you to share. So, the flaw in the position is that you've already assumed, you're assuming that the spirit is an uncreated thing. You've assumed that. There's nothing.
That discredit my assumption by proving for me spirit is created by Allah.
So I have done this.
No, you haven't.
I'll do it again.
Do it again.
Allah is Ahad. That means he is uniquely Allah. And there is nothing like him. The soul or the spirit is something that's within one of us. So it automatically, it precludes your conclusion that the spirit is. And if you go to the same, the spirit is Allah. Now if you go to the verse that you quoted in Sura 17 verse 85, and they ask you about the ruh, the spirit. The spirit is the one of the things which the knowledge is only with my Lord. And of the knowledge mankind has been giving very little. Now it says the knowledge of that spirit is in God. It doesn't say the knowledge that spirit is God. So again, this backs up the concept that this is something that no one really knows too much about, but it is not. It's not God by definition.
Do you know the verse which states Allah has a soul?
Just tell me.
I'm asking.
I've not come across that verse.
And that is what?
Allah has a soul.
So I've not come across that verse.
Allah has a soul. I'll give you that reference.
Please do.
So, since because you are starting, the Allah is ayat. So I'm not looking from that part, okay? I want you to simply prove for me that spirit is created, okay? So Quran is well detailed, well explained. Even Muhammad had a great opportunity. People went to Muhammad and then said, Muhammad, tell us who is this spirit. What this spirit is, Muhammad says, knowledge is only given.
So the
knowledge
question,
of the spirit is only belong to Allah.
Let me finish.
So, if sake of the argument, okay, sake of the argument, if the spirit is not part of Allah, according to you, okay, I will still need a reference for you to provide for that for me. Spirit is not part of the Allah, okay? So, can you just tell me, okay? So, these are the couple of verses. You need to read together to put it together, okay? So, Spirit of Allah reveals to Mary, okay? Same Spirit of Allah as he reveals to Mary, he gives, makes a baby in the tummy of Mary by blowing into her private part. Surah 66 verse 12, okay? Farsh.
So you're saying that means vagina, is that what you're saying?
I'm saying that means private parts, farsh.
So you're saying that means vagina, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, if that's how you interpret it.
That's how you interpret it.
Surah 66, verse 12.
So this for me.
Surah 66, verse 12. Let me finish my case regarding why Allah is committing shirk by telling the spirit is separate.
When you make little digs like this, it discredits your argument for me as a Muslim. It makes me in my mind turn away from anything you're trying to explain to me. So if you're sincerely trying to help me as a Muslim understand and come to Christianity, the tactics that you're using actually make me turn away from it. And I'll tell you why.
What is in Surah 66 verse 12?
So
what is that farsh mean?
So
I guess that's why you are upset.
No, I'm not upset. Do I look upset?
Okay, tell me, what does that farj mean?
So this is another thing, I'm not upset.
People, what is farj
people
mean?
People say much worse things to the puppet's face and even to me all the time. Now, sir, what my advice to you only is
I'm not going to play those games.
I'm not playing games.
Let's just
like
focus on
so
the
my
topic.
Advice to you is if you're going to make some
Sura
points...
Sura 66, yeah. Verse 12, okay? The phrase used is the farj, okay? It is the... I'll read it for you. And Mary, the daughter of Imran, who guarded her chastity, okay, that's the farj, Arabic word, which is the private part, they blow into, okay, they blow into that book which revealed to Mary in Surah 19. Okay, that book gives life to baby Jesus while blowing into her private parts.
So
and Surah 58.
So thank you for not convincing me not to take you seriously. Oh. That's what you're doing.
Awesome.
I have to thank you for that.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
The reason I thank you for that is there's many ways that you can convince me that Islam would be wrong, and there's many ways you can convince me that Christianity would be right. But lewdness is not one of them.
I am just using the language. Quran is using
some. You're not using the
language. You are trying. I gave you a couple of chances.
No.
You haven't responded to questions.
You
are just playing that game.
I'm not playing a game.
Okay?
I'm trying to.
So you are a professional victim currently. I want you to.
Okay. So
hang on. Tell me.
Another allegation. Thank you for making another allegation.
Tell me.
I appreciate that, but that's not really going to help us with the argument.
So
first of all, you started off talking about Surah Al-Ikhlas. Allah is unique, and there is nothing like him. So we established this.
You made your claims about it. I disagree because I'm making my case.
No, hang on a second. I haven't finished my thing.
I'm just correcting this. You cannot.
Oh, thank you,
jump
please. So then you said that somehow one is like I have one hand, but I have many fingers, as if within God there are components, which is what you're arguing for, because this is a Christian concept. Of, this is a Christian.
No, that's not what I am arguing
for. Arguing this,
So
the one
it
means
looks
one.
Like you are not listening. Okay.
Sounds like it.
Yeah. It looks like you're not listening. No, I just focus. Your brother, where is he? Your brother made a claim he became a Muslim because Islam was a polytheist religion.
Monotheist,
correct. Yeah. Islam was a monotheist religion. I wanted him to back it up, okay? I look at the Islamic teachings and then I don't see Islam as a monotheist religion.
But you haven't given anything
one of the you are not listening because I'm
carry on,
therefore
carry on,
I'm just
carry
repeating
on.
It again.
Sorry.
So
one of the
Surah 19 talks about Ruh of Allah appeared to Mary. Surah 66 tells us how the Ruh of Allah made Mary pregnant. Okay? So Ruh of Allah gives life and gives life to baby Jesus out of nothing. Okay?
No, how can
and
you say this?
Out of sex. We all know baby comes together after the sex. Sex doesn't take place, but Ruh of Allah, according to you, which Ruh of Allah is created, gives life, okay? Allah is the life giver, but in here, it is the Ruh of Allah creates something. And then when you link that verse, okay, with the Surah 58, 22, where we see that the Ruh of Allah is strength. All the believers are agreed for you. You will not find a people who believe in Allah and the last day having affected for those who oppose Allah and His Messenger, even if they were their fathers, or their sons, or their brothers, or their kindred. Those who has declared within their heart's faith, okay, that's talking about people who identify Allah as God and believes in the last day, okay, lots of people, and they are strengthened them with the Spirit, with the Ruh of Allah.
Ruh of Allah. You didn't say Ruh of Allah here.
With the Spirit. What Spirit?
So you tell me.
What Spirit?
So that's the thing. See, this is the thing.
That.
So what you're doing?
That which gives life, explained in the Quran, blah blah. It goes to commentary.
So where's the commentary?
No, it's just footnote. So Spirit.
Exactly.
So Spirit is the Ruh. Yeah. Okay. So if this Ruh has been created, okay, by Allah, okay, and this rule can become a perfect human, this rule can give life, and this rule in Surah 66, and this rule, okay, can strengthen all the believers, all Muslims, in today's century, 1.84 billion Muslims, okay? If it can do that, can you just tell me what kind of attributes must this spirit have? Am I right to assume all-knowing, all-powerful, and all-present? Spirit must know who are all those believers. Spirit must know. For spirit must know, it needs to be all present. How come spirit is going to know that?
Because I'm going to explain to you. Yeah? Okay. So I'm going to start at the beginning because you gave a long passage. Yeah? So first of all, Allah is Ahad, uniquely Allah. There are no components. I'm going to. If you interrupt me, then we're going to go around in circles. So I've given you a long time to explain your position. Allow me to say.
You are repeating yourself.
You did the same. You repeated yourself from the beginning, so I'm going to...
You didn't listen, I
so, so now it's my opportunity to do the same, so I'd appreciate if you gave me that time. So the first thing, Allah is Ahad. He was uniquely Allah, there is nothing like him. It says that within the verse. The spirit is the soul. It's referred to that when the people asked the Prophet about the soul. He was told that the soul is something about which you have little knowledge. The knowledge of the soul is with Allah. It doesn't mean the soul is Allah or that it's uncreated, which you're assuming. Then you've gone to a verse which talks about the angel blowing in and making Mary pregnant, as you put it. And this is angel giving life to this spirit giving life to Jesus, which you're saying that therefore the spirit has creative power. Now, if you read Sura, if you read chapter 3, I think it's verse 59, let me just find it. If you read chapter 3, verse 59, you're giving the clarification of, I think it's 59. Here we go, verse 355. And indeed the example of Jesus to Allah is like that of Adam. He created him from dust, and he said to him, be, and he was. So the command for the Adam to for Jesus to exist is the same as the command for Adam to exist who existed in the beginning. A creative force. The angel that came to give the message, the Ruh, which we identify as the angel who came to angel Gabriel came to give the message, is simply that, a message provider. Now, you talk about the spirit that's given to all the people, and you assume that because the spirit is given to all people, it must have a couple of things. It must be all powerful, all knowing, doesn't follow. If there was a spirit that was given to all the Muslims to strengthen them in their faith, Allah can give this information to that spirit to go to whoever is required. You said it has to be all present. Well, that doesn't make sense because it only goes to those people who are Muslims. Muslims are not all present anyway as individuals, so that doesn't follow. And then you said, I can't remember the third attribute that you gave it. So none of those things that you said follow. And we have the statement in the Quran that the spirit, that Jesus is like Adam for Allah. And the same way that he created Adam with the word be is the same way that that Jesus was created.
Okay, so let me break it down. You made lots of statements.
I did. I told one sentence, if you don't know. So for us, Allah is uniquely the creator. There is nothing in the creation like him. The spirit that Allah sends to give the messages are also not like Allah either.
Okay.
So to make them equivalent. To make them equivalent, and you have to show that somehow Muslims believe that their spirit is created. Okay. Which I don't think.
I don't care what Muslims believe. Oh. I'm looking at what Islam teaches. Okay. So here's a couple of things. You say there is. You are focusing on Surah 112, and then saying there is nothing like Allah. But when we look at the Islamic tradition, we know from the Islamic tradition actually Allah has human. What do you call those kind of
characteristic?
No, arms, legs.
Organs. Yeah. You're right.
Yeah, but Allah has eyes, Allah has feet, Allah has arms, Allah sits on the throne, he's got feet, those kind of things. So, the way you are interpreting Surah 112 is just very, very bad for Surah 112. But that's not my focus. I would love you.
Can you make that point again? I didn't understand.
So I would love you to unpack that when I give you time. So you told me.
Repeat the point.
Maybe listen. This is your listening
phase. The point that you made.
Put your listening face on.
I'm an adult. You're an adult. Let's
okay. Put your listening face. I'm going to repeat it again. Okay. So you say there is nothing like Allah.
Yeah.
Okay. But we look at the Islamic tradition and then we see
I'll let you finish to read your article. We look at the Islamic tradition and then we see actually Allah has human descriptions.
Yeah.
He has eyes, he sits on the throne, he's got feet, all those kind of things. And like there is, you can put the body of Allah together.
Yeah.
If you want, I can give you the reference for that little bit later. So even simply saying there is nothing like Allah goes how you are putting it together. So physical, this Allah has the physical description,
so
with the hands, fins, arms, all those kind of things. And then you simply stated, Allah created Adam same way he created
Jesus.
Show me the, from the Quran, okay? Show me from the Quran how Allah, so we all know from the Quran how Allah created Adam.
Mm.
Allah put the dust from from the clay, he made a man, he breathed into man, and then man become a human, start living, and then we look from the Islamic tradition,
Jesus.
And then Adam says to Allah, finish me before it gets dark, okay, before day finishes.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You don't know how Allah created Adam.
I don't know what you're talking about, the darkness.
So from Islamic tradition, simply we see Allah didn't say Adam, therefore be Adam. That didn't happen.
Yeah.
Allah took a dust.
Let me finish.
Allah from the mud, he made things, okay, images, and then he give that image his spirit, okay, with that breath, Adam have a life, okay. So that's how it happened. Can you show me from anywhere in Islamic tradition?
Yeah.
Remember, you said Allah created Adam the same way with Jesus. Where is it in Islamic tradition? Allah take from the earth.
So this is a
Allah take it from the earth.
Yeah.
Okay. And then made the shapes, and then breathed into that shape, and then shape turned out to be a man instead of baby or something.
So that
was your second, responding to your second point. I'm gonna respond to your fourth point. No, I'm responding your three points. Your last point was regarding Surah 58 verse 22, which you didn't remember well. So four spirit to strengthen the believers. Spirit needs to know I am not a Muslim, but spirit needs to know that you are Muslim. Therefore, spirit must be all knowing. Spirit must be all knowing. Spirit must know. By the way, as I'm giving you the reference, I'm still waiting for you to prove Allah created spirit. So spirit must know you are Muslim, I am not Muslim. Spirit must have power. It doesn't say spirit will be told.
No,
it says spirit is the one who is strengthening.
Yes.
It is not saying Allah is gonna give power to spirit.
Spirit so already
has the power. I'm not arguing
you're
from something. I love you to back those things up.
Spirit must be
all powerful, all knowing, and all present. And this is the spirit.
So the thing is you're
and
making
this
statements
is the spirit where it becomes
so again,
a perfect human and then give life to Jesus. Now your point.
Okay.
Before we move, can you please first
provide reference for me? If you're giving me
first provide reference for me that spirit is created?
Okay.
Because yours argument,
if the
spirit is created.
You're not able to impose upon me a question if you're going to give me my time to speak to about what you've said. You've said many things. So let me go through. I said many things
and then you said many things.
So let me,
all
let
the
me,
conversation
so me,
started because you said spirit.
This side of the conversation.
No,
we have to start from the conversation.
Because this side of the conversation started when you said Allah created spirit. So if you back that up, that would be very helpful.
So the first thing is Allah is.
So you are not able to back it up.
I'm gonna. So there we go. Just because someone's speaking and I'm not gonna agree with your point.
Yeah, listen to you, please.
You're talking.
Carry on, brother. Carry on.
Brother,
just carry on.
Then you have to be quiet for that.
No, why are you being rude to him?
I'm not, because he's talking.
You're being rude. He's being
quiet. Sorry.
Yeah. Don't be rude to a gentleman.
You know he's being quiet.
Okay, you guys finish our talk. So tell me.
No, but why are you being rude to the man?
You already expressed that you are adult. Okay, when I tell you to listen, why you are googling something?
So why are you?
Can you just simply for us to continue and go forward, first pick up your place that Allah created the spirit, and then after respond what are the statements I made.
Okay, so I will give you my answer if you actually want to listen to my answer. If you don't want to, that's entirely up to yourself. So number one, Allah is Ahad, is uniquely Allah. There is no components to Allah, and you've mentioned this a few times repeatedly, so I'm repeating that. And there is nothing like Allah. And the spirit is something, the soul is something that we're told in the Quran that we will possess the soul, and it's nothing that we know anything about apart from Allah. So because we will possess the soul, automatically from the definition that Allah is uniquely Allah and there is nothing like Him, it is not Allah. So that's already, that's determined from those two verses coming together. The imposition or that you're making upon me is that the ruh is uncreated. That's your claim. I don't accept this because the verses in the Quran tell me that He's uncreated. Because why? Allah is Ahad and there is nothing like Him, and we know that the soul, which we all have in us, is therefore not Allah by automatically, because the same way that the tree is not Allah, our souls are not Allah, it's the same thing. Then you went on to talk, then you made a false analogy, and the false analogy is this. You said, I don't know, I'm sorry, you made the analogy that because Allah says the way that Allah created Adam is the same way that He created Jesus by saying the command be, you're saying that the process has to be the same. That's a fallacy, because Allah, Adam was created without parents. Jesus was created from a mother only. So your false analogy is that somehow they have to be exactly the same way. That's not what's being shown as being the same. What is being shown as being the same is the command be and it is. Now, what you're saying to me, contrary to the Quranic verse 359, is that that command be is not what's being spoken about, but the process of how Allah is made, and you talk about the clay and show me how Jesus was made from clay. False analogy, you're conflating two different things and you're making them the same. They're not the same. So what do we know? Allah is one, uniquely one. There is nothing like Him. The soul is ubiquitous because we all have the soul within us. Therefore, automatically by definition, that cannot be Allah, because why? He's uniquely one, there is nothing like Him. Then we're told about the soul, that it's something that Allah knows about, and Muhammad, peace be upon him, was not given this knowledge. Fine. That does not mean that it was somehow part of Allah or created. That's simply an assertion. And I understand the assertion because this is the Christian Trinitarian mindset, that's the visions that you're looking through to the Quran. You won't find the Trinity in the Quran. It just doesn't happen. Because Allah is one, uniquely one, and He's always alone. We're told it's alone. So when you find the word alone, that automatically means there is no other. No partners, no combinations with Him. So that's that point. Now, the other
thing... I need to respond to that point before I forget the question.
Okay, so I'll let you do that.
I have given you time to prove for me, since you are disagreeing with me, that... But I am putting together... Ruh of Allah, Spirit of Allah is part of Allah. It's the same. Speech of Allah would be the part of Allah.
No.
It wouldn't be separated from Allah.
No.
So, if you are disagreeing that Spirit of Allah is separated from Allah and it is creating being, I am simply asking, give me reference for that, and you have not given me any reference if the Spirit of Allah, as you stated, is a created being by Allah, I am simply asking you to provide a reference for me. Okay? Please give me a reference for that. And in somehow you are putting the spirit and then the soul together, but Quran uses spirit and soul in different occasions, and Quran even has different Arabic words for that. So what is your authority that you go against your Quran and then tell me spirit and the soul are the same? Because remember, in Surah 1785, question is about the spirit, and then Allah says knowledge is only to Allah. So Allah doesn't say, remember, that is great opportunity. Allah could say spirit and the soul are the same and they are the similar things or something. Allah doesn't say that. So I want you to back up, soul and spirit are the same. I would really, really appreciate it if you just help me to put together, how did you come to the conclusion, as I'm talking about the spirit, that you understood that I was talking about the human spirit? I never made any claim that it is your spirit or my spirit can give life or strength to believers or can become a perfect man.
That's a good point.
I am talking about His spirit.
See, that's a good point.
I sent Him our spirit, okay? I'm talking about there is unique spirit up there. If that unique spirit up there
created by Allah, Allah is asking people and teaching in the Quran to commit shirk. So that's the first point. Second point is regarding Adam and Jesus is made to be with the commandment of Allah as being. Then simply Quran disagrees. In the, Allah never says, oh, let me make a man, and then therefore Adam happened. There is a process for Adam to happen, and there is a process for Jesus to be happen. So I wasn't comparing them in a biological sense, I was comparing them in the statements Allah says, Allah made Adam and Jesus, Allah said be, and therefore it is. But that is simply not true. Allah didn't create Adam with B. Allah didn't create Jesus with B. So those are the points you make.
Can you
please
back that last statement? No? Allah didn't create Adam with B.
Surah 3.
So it basically
Surah 3 verse 59. Indeed. The example of Jesus to Allah is like that of Adam. He created him from dust, then he said to him, be, and there he was. Okay? So I want you to... The truth is from your Lord, so do not be among the doubters. So, therefore, you need to prove for me Adam and Jesus has been created same thing. Because in the Quran, Allah tells us how Allah created Adam. Okay, gives us the process of that. Allah doesn't say, when Allah gives the process, oh, hold on a minute, I remembered in Surah 359, I stated be and therefore it was. Now I need to create Adam like that. Allah doesn't do that. Allah spends whole afternoon to create Adam. Okay, if you don't understand what I'm saying, I'm going to break it down. Simply, I am asking, give me the verses which tells you how Adam is created, and then which tells you how Jesus is created. That's a simple question I am asking, because I can't find those verses in the Quran. So they're supposed to be with B, but it doesn't take place.
So the Quran itself states that Adam and Jesus were created by the command B. It says that. You read the verse. So what you're saying is just show me the process. And the process...
So show me if that's how it happened.
So it's what the Quran says it does. So for me that's sufficient. But for you as a non-Christian...
No, because I am looking at other verses from the Quran.
Sure.
Which tells me how Allah created Adam.
And
so it's not those verses agree with Surah 3.
The verse states itself quite simply that the Quran says that Adam was created the same way that Jesus was, using the command B. Now you're claiming that the process has to be the same. I've said to you that the difference is, so I'm just going to finish my sentence, the difference is that Adam was created without parents, and the process therefore is different to how Jesus was created because he had a mother. So he was created into the womb of Mary. A different process. But the command was the same, which is what this verse is referring to.
Not referring to that. So, you are imposing that into the verse.
Cool.
Okay? Because I already told you, other verses
which tells us
how Allah created Adam, Allah created Jesus.
This is like a dead horse that you're talking. It's not going to go anywhere. Because we disagree.
If we want, so,
we can disagree about it.
Okay, we disagree with that. I'll go home from that with saying, you do not understand what your scripture says.
You can do that, but I
can
then
check it out.
So I don't agree with that argument.
Okay,
so,
in that case, if you're not going to agree with anything, let's go to the beginning and then you give me the verse from the Quran, which tells you Allah created spirit, and also back it up when you say spirit and the soul are the same.
Okay, so first of all, let me give you something that clarifies to you who the spirit is, because that might make things a little bit easier for you, because you're struggling with this, because you think somehow the spirit is the spirit of Allah. And so if you go to chapter 14, Surah 16, if you go to verse 102, I'll start from verse 101. It says, and then when we change a verse in the place of another, and Allah knows best what he sends down, the believers say that you are nothing but a forger, nay, but most of them know not. The next verse, to say the Ruh al-Qudus, the Holy Spirit, has brought it down from your Lord with truth,
that it may make firm those and strengthen those in the faith of those who believe, and as a guidance and a glad tidings to those who sustain. So Allah says that the Quran.
That was the 16102.
Okay. So let me finish. I haven't finished. So Allah's talking about when Allah brings a verse in exchange for another verse, that the people were saying to the Prophet Muhammad that you were, peace upon him, a forger. And Allah says in the next verse, no, I have sent down the Holy Spirit with it, the verse, so that it would lead people to faith in the truth. Now, so we from this, we identify the spirit of the Ruh al-Qudus, the spirit of truth, as being the one who brought the Quran to the Prophet Muhammad. Clear from the verse, no other interpretation of this. And we know that to be faithful. So we know this. So we have
I need you to back it up. Which states that Spirit of Allah is the Gabriel.
So this is the verse that does that. We sent down the verse that they changed. With the Spirit of Truth. So the Spirit of Truth, the Ruh al-Qudus, the Holy Spirit, that you're referring to as Allah, is actually that spirit which Allah sent down with the change in the verse of the Prophet Muhammad. So it is the angel who brought the revelation to the Prophet Muhammad. It's clear from the verse. So the whole thesis that you're bringing together, in the light of this verse, collapses.
Let me just ask you a question. Now, are you telling me, as Ruh al-Qudus, spirit and the soul and the angel Gabriel are all the same?
I'm not saying that.
You said the spirit Ruh al-Qudus is the Gabriel, okay?
Yeah.
And then you say spirit and the soul are the one.
Two different concepts for this.
Spirit and the soul are the one.
So I spoke about
I'm asking. So you've got the spirit, you've got the soul, and then you've got the Gabriel. Are they all one being? If it is all one being, why in somehow Allah failed to explain that in Surah 17? And why Allah is not only didn't explain to that, but Allah gives qualities to the spirit?
So I'm going to work backwards because I can't remember the beginning of what you said. So first of all, Allah didn't give his qualities to the spirit. You're claiming this, but I've said to you before that the argument that you make about the verse doesn't follow. To do all those things that the spirit was given to do, you don't need to be all powerful, you don't need to be all knowing, you don't have to be omnipresent.
How can you?
I'll explain further, but this is, I've said this before, I don't want to repeat it now, but I'll do it in a moment if you want me to. That's the first point.
That doesn't match. Are
you on YouTube?
No, let me finish. The spirit doesn't have to have all these qualities automatically, you're assuming that they do. Second thing, the verse when he talks about the soul nobody knows much about the soul except for Allah is referring to the human soul, because that's what the question that was given to the
Prophet. Right. How do you know that?
Because we have this
verse. The verse doesn't say that.
The verse doesn't say that. We know this from the context of revelation. I can find that for you. I've read it before and I can bring it to you next time I meet you and I can show you. But anyone who wants to look,
you
can actually put it
on
the context.
So you are making lots of claims.
The spirit we're told clearly in 16 verse 101 and 102 is referring specifically to the angel Gabriel
I think the Croatian team.
So with the verse I quoted,
they like pray and everything. Yeah.
Tells you that Allah sends the verses down with the Ruh al-Qudus to the Prophet Muhammad. Okay, so first step.
No, I am okay with that.
Let me explain this to you.
So they're talking about the spirit now. Whether he's divine or not.
And what happens is I make one point and you interrupt me, so I'm not able to make the second point. So the first point is that we know that the Ruh al-Qudus is that which brought the verses to the Prophet Muhammad. We know this. Islamic sources, and many of them, and I'll quote them for you, I'll bring them to you, show that the angel that was bringing the revelation to the Prophet Muhammad was Gabriel. We know this. Okay? If you want to deny that, that's entirely up to you.
So you don't have any verse in the Quran which states our sources Ruhul Qudus is the angel. Is that?
No, you're making a false statement.
Is that any verse in the Quran tells you Ruhul Qudus is the angel Gabriel?
Okay, can I speak? Or you want to ask the question?
No, just answer the question and then we move on. I've been here
I think it's a while.
There is no
over an hour. Do you guys want to summarize?
It's been over an hour, sir.
We can summarize and come back later. But there is no yes or no answers to this. We're going to have to disagree. But for me, so I'll summarize.
Sorry, if you don't mind. They're going to summarize anyway.
So, as a Muslim, I believe that God is one. And that Islam is a monotheistic religion, and God is uniquely one and not my creation. And we worship God alone, and we follow His messengers.
Thank you so
much. Prophet Muhammad, Jesus, and then Moses going back.
But they've been going for a while. Tell them, get them.
And the revelation was given to the Prophet Muhammad by the angel Gabriel, who is the one who produced the revelation from the Quran. And that there is no concept that the Ruh al-Qudus is somehow Allah in the Quran. I don't accept
it.
I agree that I haven't given you all the references you wanted. I accept that perfectly. And next time I see you, I'll give you the I tend to come every 2 or 3 weeks, but whenever I'm here next, I'll make a point to find you and I'll give you those references. But I think it's very clear, community established. I don't think I was prepared for that topic specifically, but I can find the verses for next year. I'll leave the rest.
So, that's fine. I'm quite happy for you to put in the references for me. But you made a claim that the spirit is created. So, if the spirit is created, my argument still stands. That spirit is capable to give life. That spirit is all-powerful, all-present, and all-knowing. You need to provide for me, first of all. You need to provide for me that spirit is created by Allah. You need to provide for me. It will make big mess if the spirit is created by Allah, because Allah is committing shirk by giving His attributes to others. So when you bring it that, we will discuss that.
Yeah.
You need to bring your evidence for me that Quran states that Ruh al-Qudus is the angel Gabriel. I love you to give me that reference. 16:102 simply states that revelation was given through Zarruh. I'm asking, that was Turkish, Ruh al-Qudus. So I'm simply asking you to show me that Ruh al-Qudus is identified as Angel Gabriel.
Okay.
So I want you to bring me your reference for that. Also, I want you to bring your other reference that soul and the spirit are the same. I'm asking simple those questions. So when you come back, I will want to see the references, but so far, from my perspective, even though Muslims claim that Islam is a monotheist religion, and even it is, I noticed that you don't even understand who the spirit is, like Allah doesn't understand here, it helps me to see that actually it is only Allah who commits shirk by creating something, by giving His attributes on that creating beings.
Okay.
So when you bring your references next week, in 2 weeks, we continue to discuss that.
But you know the